morning students. In the previous video lesson, we learnt a two-column cash book. Two-column cash book, that is bank column and a discount column, and the second type, cash column and a discount column, that we discussed in the previous video lesson. In this video lesson, we are going to learn about three column cash book. So we know three column cash book means a discount column, cash column and a bank column. These are the three columns we have in three column cash book. Of course, here also we have the same procedure. Whatever the procedure we are follow in single column cash book and double column cash book, same procedure is to be followed here also. But one thing you have to remind, whenever we have discount, that is to be recorded in discount column. Whenever we have cash transactions, then cash then in the cash column we have to record. Bank transactions we have, then we have to record in the bank column. These are the instructions we have to follow where we go through in three column cash book. So let us continue this three column cash book. So one by one we will see. Here we see, here we are observing one three column cash book problem. Here make out the three column cash book of Messrs. Suresh and Naveen from the following particulars. In 2008 May 1st, cash in hand 500 rupees. Bank overdraft 650 rupees, paid salaries for April month, that is 450 rupees, purchased goods for cash, that is 20 rupees, cash sales 60 rupees. So on May 4th issued check in favor at Verma and Company to settle his account for 370 rupees. On May 5th received cash from Sony and Company, here 275 rupees, discount allowed 25 rupees. Received check from AS Brothers on May 6th, that is 290 rupees, in full settlement of their debt of rupees 300. On May 6th again cash sent to bank, that is 300 rupees. One more transaction we have, that is May 6th check issued in favored for purchase of furniture, that is 250. On May 7th, check of AS Brothers dishonored, bank debits its respect of charges 250 rupees. On May 7th, paid rent by check 200 rupees. Bank collects interest on securities, that is 250 rupees. So this is the problem. In this problem, we have three columns information. These three column information we have to post whether it is receipt or payment, that we have to observe. After observing, we have to post if it is receipt, then we have to post on debit side. If it is payment, we have to write post on credit side. So like that, whether it is cash column, cash transaction, bank transaction or discount, whatever it is, according to the problem, we have to post into appropriate columns. Then we will see. So this problem solution is like this. So here you are observing a three column cash book. So on debit side you are observing a discount allowed and a cash rupees cash column and a bank column. These are the three columns we have on debit side. The same columns we will have on credit side also. So this is an account. So here we have two halves, left side part and right side part. Left side part is known as debit, right side part is known as credit. So on debit side we have to write all the payments, maybe cash or bank. On credit side we have to write all the cash and the bank payments. So like that we have to record all the receipts on debit side, all the payments on credit side. So let us see one by one. So on 2008 May 1st, cash in hand, that is 500 rupees, bank overdraft 650 rupees. These are the opening balances. These are the opening balance. Cash in hand is nothing but it is to be recorded on debit side in cash column. Bank overdraft is to be recorded on credit side of the cash book. Because this is overdraft balance, we are indebted to bank. So you observe this on 2005 May 1st, to balance brought down 500 rupees in the cash column. This is opening balance. This is the opening balance. You can say this is the closing balance of previous month day. Previous month day. That closing balance is carry forwarded to the next day. That is this month. That is May 1st. That's why it is recorded on debit side. In the same way, the previous year month day balance, that is 650 rupees bank balance, that is credit balance we have. This credit balance is to be brought down. That's why when we are writing on debit side, we have to write 2. On credit side, we have to start with by balance brought down 650 rupees in the bank column, because this is overdraft. This is overdraft. That's why we have to write on credit side. Right? I think you got an idea. If cash balance is there, then simply you have to write on debit side. If it is not overdraft, then you have to write on debit side. If it is overdraft, you have to write on credit side. That is the instructions you have to follow. First, this opening balance is to be taken properly. Otherwise, you will be mistaken. So next we will see. Next item, paid salaries for April month, that is 450 rupees. Paid salaries, paid nothing but payment. So that's why May 1st, by salaries 450 rupees, in the form of cash, in terms of cash we paid. So that's why cash is paid. So it is to be recorded in the cash column. So that's why 450 is to be recorded in cash column. So that's why you are observing it is recorded in cash column. Next, on May 3rd, purchased goods for cash, that is 20 rupees. Here, we purchased goods for cash, that is 20 rupees. Cash yields 60 rupees. So, one item is purchase, one item is sales. Those are cash transactions. So, that's why you have to record purchase are to be recorded on payment side, sales recorded on debit side. So, you see, by purchase 20 rupees on credit side, and on debit side to sales 60 rupees on debit side. Because when we are selling, we are receiving cash. When we are purchasing goods, then we are paying amount. So that's why on credit side by purchase, on debit side to sales 60 rupees. Next item, on May 4th, issued check in favor at Verma and Company to settle his account for 370 rupees. So a check issued in favor at Verma and Company to settle his account for 370 rupees. So issued is nothing but payment. So that's why Verma and Company. So here have given issued a check in favor at Verma and Company to settle his account for 370. So here one check is issued to Verma and Company. So that's why it is to be recorded on payment side. Here you are observing check issued. So that's why it is to be recorded in bank column. That is 360 rupees and gaining 10 rupees discount. Of course, in the problem we have not given, but we have to take it as. Here you write 360 rupees. Then it will be clear. Next. On May 5th, received cash from Sony and Company. We have received cash from Sony and Company. That is 275 rupees. So on debit side, to Sony and Company, we are receiving 275 rupees and 25 rupees is discount allowed. 25 rupees discount allowed. So that's why in the discount column, we are writing 25 rupees. In the cash column, 275, we are writing. So next, on May 6th, received a check from AS Brothers. That is 290 rupees. We are receiving a check from AS Brothers in full settlement of their debt of rupees 300. So we are receiving a check. So that's why you see on debit side May 6th to AS Brothers 290 rupees in the bank column and 10 rupees in the discount column. So totally we have to receive 300 rupees. Instead of 300, we are receiving 290 rupees only. The remaining 10 rupees is discount allowed to him, allowed to the company. So that's why 290 rupees check is received. So that's why it is debited and the discount is recorded in the discount column. Next. On May 6th, cash sent to bank. That is 300 rupees. So here we are sending bank cash to bank. So on May 6th, by bank 300 rupees, we are sending cash. That means cash balance is decreasing. That is nothing but cash payment is done. So that's why cash balance is going to be reduced. That's why 300 is to be recorded on credit side. The same amount is recorded in the bank column on the same day. So that's why on May 6th to cash 300 rupees in the bank column, because here only one transaction but two columns are affected. So cash column is recorded to reduce the balance, bank column is recorded to increase the balance. So one transaction bank balance is increased and cash column is cash is decreased. So that's why this type of transaction is known as contra. So that's why it is to be recorded with the help of C. The C letter indicates contra. This contra is to be recorded in the ledger folio column. So whatever the transaction we are affected in both the sides, then it is to be treated as contra. That contra in entry is to be indicated with C, capital C. So one transaction, two effects. So that you have to remind. Next one, on May 6th, check issued in favor for purchase of furniture, that is 250 rupees. So purchase furniture 250 rupees we are paying. So check is issued. So next one, on May 7th, check of AS Brothers dishonored bank debits its respect of charges 250 rupees. So earlier we received from AS Brothers, that is 250 check issued in the favor for purchase of furniture, that is 250 rupees. Alright. So 250 rupees. Right. 270 rupees, sorry. Check issued in favor for purchase of furniture, that is done. Check of AS Brothers. So earlier AS Brothers, so we can see AS Brothers, right. So on May 6th, received a check from A's brothers, that is 290 rupees. One check is received and deposited into bank, but it is dishonored by the bank. Then the respective charges are debited. So that's why 290 plus 4 rupees. How do we get 4 rupees? Not mentioned now. This one or bank debits is respective charges. Okay, 294 rupees. And again, paid rent by check, that is 200 rupees. We are paying rent, that is 200 rupees. It is recorded on bank column on credit side. Next, a bank collects interest on securities, that is 250 rupees. So 250 rupees is collected by the bank in the form of interest. So that is recorded in the bank column of debit. So that's why this is on May 7th recorded. Now all the transactions are recorded. All the transactions are recorded. Then we have to balance. So except discount column, remaining cash and bank columns are to be balanced, except discount column, whether it is discount allowed or discount received. Except a discount column, remaining two columns are to be balanced. So that's why here you see discount allowed, this column gives the total 35 rupees. Just you have to write the total amount, don't balance it. The same way, discount received, this total is 20 rupees, don't balance it. So on debit side, discount 35 rupees, on credit side, discount 20 rupees. So that's why don't balance it. Next, cash column. So when we total cash column on debit side, it gives us 835 rupees. From that, all the credit payments in the cash column, that is to be deducted, that is to be deducted. Then we get remaining balance, that is 65 rupees we will get. 65 rupees we will get. So from 835, remaining 450, 20 and 300 is to be deducted. Then remaining balance is 65. This balance 65 is recorded as balance carry forwarded. Carry forwarded. So that is 65 rupees. The same like, so whatever we balanced the cash column, the same way we have to balance bank column also. So here bank column, credit balance is higher. Credit balance is higher. That means more than in our account we utilized. More than the bank balance we utilized. So that's why here total, whenever we total in the bank column, 1754 is the balance. 1754 is the balance. The same balance is to be recorded here. From that, three balances, that is 290, 300 and 250 is to be deducted. Remaining balance is 914. This 914 is to be recorded as to balance carry forwarded. To balance carry forwarded. Okay. This carry forward balances is to be recorded for the next month, that is next day. So that's why by balance brought down 914 rupees, because in the bank column we are observing 914 rupees is the balance. This is credit balance, that's why you have to record on credit side on June 1st. So that is May 31st. The next day is June 1st. By balance brought down, that is 914 rupees. In the same way, on June 1st, cash column we have 65 rupees debit balance. So that's why you have to write on debit side to balance brought down 65 rupees. Okay, now the problem is over. Like this, you have to prepare three column cash book. So next problem we will see. One more problem on three column cash book. Here, enter the following transactions in various subsidiary books and post them to ledger and prepare a trial balance. This is regarding to trial balance, not for three column. Of course, first you have to prepare three column cash book. After that, you have to prepare trial balance. So in the next video lesson, we will try to do trial balance problems. Okay. Now this problem is utilized for three column cash book. Three column cash book. So that's why the same problem is used to prepare three column cash book, right? So 2016 June 1st, cash in hand ₹15,700, cash at bank ₹25,400, and the capital account ₹41,100. And third, bought goods for cash for ₹4,100, purchased goods from Meera and Company for ₹5,800, less 10% discount, trade discount. Sold goods to Bedi and Company for ₹8,900, less 20% trade discount. Withdrew ₹500 from bank for private use. Sold goods to Amjad Khan for ₹6,400. ₹5,000 paid to Meera and Company in full settlement of their account. Goods worth ₹400 returned by Amjad Khan. Received ₹4,000 from Amjad Khan. Purchased goods from Shiv Dayal and Company for ₹8,700. ₹6,000 paid to Shiv Dayal and Company by check. Discount allowed ₹300. Purchased furniture for ₹800 from Manjit Furniture House on credit. Paid into bank ₹2,200. Amjad Khan declared insolvent. A first and final dividend of 50 paise in a rupee is received from him. Next one, a goods worth 600 returned to Shiv Dayal and Company. Interest on capital provided 411. Goods worth 400 taken by the proprietor for his personal use. Paid ₹500 for advertisement by check. On June 30, paid salaries to staff, that is 1800, cash sales 21,800, and paid into bank 20,000, bought 100 shares in Hindi Mill Limited at ₹11 per share, brokerage paid ₹25. Next, on 30, received 5,900 from Bedi and Company, discount allowed ₹100. This is the problem. This problem is to be posted into three column cash book. So that's why let us see in the earlier problem also we discussed in three column cash book. We have three columns, discount, cash and bank columns. The three columns we will have on debit side and credit side, the same problem, but number of transaction is more in this problem. Let us see, then you will get an idea by doing this problem also. So next we will see. So this is a partition. This is left side, this is right side. So left side all the receipts are to be recorded, credit side all the payments are to be recorded. So first one, cash in hand 15,700, cash at bank 25,400. This is to be recorded first, 15,700 and 25,400. So in the date column, we have to write date, that is 2016 June 1st. In particulars column, we have to start with in debit side, that is 2. To balance brought down in the cash column 15,700, in the bank column 25,400. Right. Next, capital account 41,100. So this is also a receipt, 41,100. Same date, cash in hand, cash at bank and capital account 41,100. 41,100. bought goods for cash for 4100. We purchased. When we are purchasing, we have to record 4100 and in cash column by purchase account. Next, purchased goods from Meera and Company for 5800, less than percentage discount. Yes. On fourth date, we purchased 5800 worth. 5800 worth. 5800 worth. Meera and Company. So here, 5800. This problem. Where is the calculator? Control. Right, so some problem is mistaken. 5001% means discount purchased goods. When you are purchasing, payment has to be done. So 10% discount. This problem is problem. So next we will see the continuation part, that is a petty problem. Petty cash book. So in this petty cash book, we see petty cash book. So petty cash book. Here a prepare columnar petty cash book on imprest system from the following particulars. Received for petty cash payments 2000 rupees on July 1st. Next, third, paid for postage 90 rupees, paid for stationery 60 rupees, paid for advertisement 200, paid for wages 60 rupees, paid for carriage 50 rupees, paid for conveyance 66 rupees, paid for traveling expenses 260 rupees, paid for postage 200 rupees, wages to office cleaner 40 rupees, paid for telegrams 60 rupees, sent a registered notice to landlord 9 rupees. So this is the problem. So this problem is to be prepared petty column cash book. This petty column cash book is to be prepared for the analysis of petty expenses. So all the cash transactions are recorded maybe in single column, two column, three column. But sometimes the company or the organization has to pay petty expenses. That petty expenses are to be recorded and analyzed. So which expenditure is more, which expenditure is not to be done, which expenditure is to be done. So like that, the total analytical information is to be gathered for decision making to the management. So that's why all the petty expenditure is to be recorded here, right? So this is the problem. The solution is to be seen in the next screen. So here the debit column is reduced to only one column, credit columns are expanded, So you see amount received column. Amount received column is debit column. Cash book folio, the page number we have to write from where we are recording. Cash book is nothing but maybe three column cash book. Maybe three column cash book page number we have to write here. A date. This date column is useful for both the sides. Maybe debit, maybe credit. For both the sides, we use this date column. And particulars. Particulars are so, for both the columns, it is to be used. It is to be used. On debit side, it is to be recorded 2. On credit side, it is to be recorded with by. So, like that, we have to differentiate a debit particulars and a credit particulars. So, this is voucher number. Sometimes we may get voucher number, sometimes we may not get voucher, because all the petty expenditure may not get detailed vouchers. Maybe whatever it is, may not be possible to maintain vouchers. Of course, we have to get vouchers. Here, payment, whatever the amount we are paying, the total amount. Here, columns, columns for analysis purpose, columns for analysis purpose. This is the amount for payment, whatever the amount we paid, that is payment amount, payment, the total amount we paid. So, for this amount, sometimes we may paid on one nature of transaction only, we paid again and again. So, that's why analysis is needed. So, that's why we have to maintain separate columns for each and every expenditure, each and every petty transaction. So, that's why here you are observing postage and telegraph. So, whenever we are paying postage and telegraph expenditure, in this column we have to write. In this column we have to write. So, for printing and stationery column, we have to write in this column. Of course, we are writing the total column, even though we have to analyze. For analysis purpose, again we are writing one more column. We are maintaining one more column. For advertisement, we have to write wages and carriage, that is recorded here. Conveyance, traveling expenses. So, like that, we may have more number of columns in credit side, because analysis purpose. So, at the end of the month, we can see on what we are paying more expenditure, on what we are paying less expenditure. So, like that, analysis purpose, we have to record. So, you see one by one. Right. So, received for petty cash payments, that is 2000 rupees. Received for petty cash payments 2000 rupees. It is to be recorded on debit side. So, 2000 rupees is received. That's why on debit side we have to write. So, on 1st July 2007, on debit side, we have to start with 2 to bank. 2000 rupees. This is the opening balance. This is the balance brought down from the cashier. So, this cash book is maintained by petty cashier. This cash book is maintained by petty cashier. So, that's why only petty cashier record all these transactions. Right? Right. You see, on 3rd paid for postage 90 rupees. Yes, on 3rd by postage payment, you see payment, when it is payment you have to start with by, when it is receipt you have to start with 2. So, that's why on 3rd payment by postage 90 rupees we paid, the total amount is to be recorded here. The same one more column we have to maintain, how much amount we are paying. So, like that we have to get the detailed information. So, that's why 90 rupees is recorded in the postage and telegraph. So, on 7th, paid for stationery 60 rupees. Paid for 60 rupees. Yes, payment 60 rupees. Printing and stationery. Next, paid for advertisement 200 rupees. Advertisement 200. Yes, 200 advertisement. Paid for wages 60 rupees. 60 rupees is to be recorded. Of course, here wages means a small amount, not for salaries and not for wages. Those who are the office and the administrative work, it is not to be recorded here. Only a small amount is to be paid. So wages 60 rupees is to be recorded in the total column. You have to write, and the same you have to record in the separate column. Next, on July 15th, paid for carriage, that is 50 rupees paid. Payments is more here, receipts are less. Carriage 50 rupees. So here for wages and carriage we have maintained only one column, so that's why 50 rupees is recorded. Next, paid for conveyance 66 rupees. Yes, conveyance 66 rupees. For conveyance we are maintaining the another column. Next, paid for traveling expenses 260 rupees. Traveling expenses, yes, on 23rd by traveling expenses 260, it is maintained for separate column, because traveling expenses is another column, it is another type of expenditure. So next, paid for postage 200 rupees. Yes, postage we are paying by postage 200 rupees, the total amount. Again, we have to record in the postage and the telegraph column, because we have to know how much amount we paid and how many times we paid for postage and telegraph. So next, wages to office cleaner. For office cleaner, we have to pay. Yes, a small amount. Earlier we discussed wages to office cleaner. So 40 rupees. This 40 rupees is to be paid. Next, paid for telegram 60 rupees. 60 rupees. Yes, telegram 60 rupees. Is 60 rupees again you have to record in the telegram column. Sent a registered notice to landlord, that is 9 rupees. Yes, postage 9 rupees in the total column and into concerned column. Now all the transactions are recorded in petty cash book. Now here we have to total. First we have to total all the separate columns, special columns. So whatever we have in traveling charges is only 260. Conveyance we have 66. So wages and carriage we have 150. Advertisement we have 200. So printing and stationery 60 rupees. Postage and telegraph 359. Like that we have to total the separate columns first. Total the separate column. Then we have to total the payment on credit side, then we get ultimately 1055. At the same time we have to check again, all these total payments are to be tallied with 1055. Okay, now in debit column we have 2000 rupees, in credit column we have 1055. Now we have to balance it. We have to balance it. 2000 remaining 945 rupees. This 945 rupees is to be carry forwarded. So first we have to write by balance carry forwarded, that is 945. And the next day we have to write to balance brought down on August 1st, that is 945 rupees. So like that we have to close all the columns. So this is petty cash book. So this is known as analytical petty cash book also. Under imprest system also we are maintaining this petty cash book. Okay, I think you got the idea. Petty cash book and
three column cash book. These are the columns we have to maintain. Three column cash book, we have three columns, that is discount column, cash column and a bank column. In petty column cash book, we have only one column for debit and more number of columns in credit side, because we have to analyze on what amount we are paying more and what on how many times we are paying. So like that, we have required for analytical purpose. So that's why we have to record on petty cash book. So with this, we are going to conclude this cash book problems. So in earlier video, we know the theory part, all the subsidiary books theory part. So that's why with this, the cash book, single column, two columns, that is completed in the previous lesson, video lesson. In this video lesson, we have completed three column cash book and the petty column cash book. So in the next video lesson, we will go for trial balance, why we prepare trial balance, and what is the how do we prepare a trial balance, for on what purpose we are preparing, what are to be taken in trial balance. So that's why in the next video lesson, we will see what is trial balance, how do we prepare, what are the methods are there. So like that, we will observe and learn in the next video lesson. With this, this video lesson, we are concluding. Please subscribe my YouTube channel. You understand, you can see again and again. If you didn't get any idea, you can contact me through WhatsApp or in whatever the mode, I will clarify the doubts. So that's why. So all the students are subscribe my channel, and please watch my YouTube channel. Thank you one and all. So with this, I'm concluding this video lesson.